Good evening. This is Jonathan with the National Weather Service in Norman, Oklahoma, with a severe weather briefing that will cover severe weather chances for Saturday through Monday, May 18th through the 20th. This briefing was recorded on Thursday, May 16th, 2013 at 5:30 p.m. This briefing is going to cover severe weather chances Saturday through Monday. This will cover the potential on Saturday, which should be completely controlled by the cap strength and the heating of the environment. Better chances for severe weather will be Sunday and Monday as a dry line surges to the east off the panhandles and a better environment develops across central Oklahoma and northern Texas. Let's go ahead and take a look at the Day 3 severe weather outlook. This will cover Saturday. At the moment, the Storm Prediction Center has a C-text region over most of central and western Oklahoma and northern Texas. This means that general thunderstorms can be expected, including severe storms. However, highly organized severe weather is not anticipated at this time. Moving into the extended outlooks, days 4 through 8. At the moment, the Storm Prediction Center has days 4 and days 5 covered, which would be Sunday and Monday respectively, as an increased chance for organized significant severe weather. Going into detail now for Saturday. At the moment, the dry line will stall out across the Texas Panhandle, maybe creep its way into far western Oklahoma, but for the most part, storms will be more focused across southwestern Oklahoma and northern Texas. At the moment, any severe storms that do develop will be capable of producing damaging wind and large hail. Most likely timing will probably be late in the afternoon, moving east, and then during the evening hours for the rest of the state. Most of these storms will be isolated and widely scattered in nature. Moving on to Sunday, the chance for severe weather increases significantly. The dry line will surge farther to the east across western Oklahoma and portions of northern Texas. When this occurs, you'll end up with a cold front that sags southward across the Oklahoma-Kansas border. Near the intersection of these two boundaries, you'll have the best potential for severe weather development, but all along the dry line, there'll be plenty of convergence, and the environment will be very primed for thunderstorm development. Tornadoes will be probably more likely near the intersection of the cold front and the dry line. At the moment, it's hard to tell exactly how our environment will look for tornado development, but we are pretty confident in damaging wind and large hail being very possible with these storms. Most of these storms will once again be widely scattered across the area. Moving into Monday, the cold front will end up sagging southward, kind of becoming a stationary front across northern central Oklahoma. The dry line will also push farther to the east, almost to central Oklahoma, just west of the Oklahoma City metro. Most likely timing of storms, again on Monday, will be in the afternoon and evening. Damaging wind and large hail will be the primary threats. At the moment, tornadoes do look possible, but specifics are still unclear given the advanced time frame. So continue to check back for updated forecast for both Sunday and Monday, especially with the impacts of possible tornadoes, large damaging hail, and damaging winds. To cover in brief, severe weather chances do look to increase for Saturday through Monday. The cap will play the role on Saturday as to whether organized convection is able to develop across the area. If stronger storms are able to develop, damaging hail and winds will be the primary threats. For Sunday through Monday, the dry line pushes east both days, and this will result in large hail and damaging winds, very possible with any storms that develop, and tornadoes will also be possible, mainly near the intersection of that cold front and dry line across the northwestern portion of the state. With that said, have a severe weather plan now and be ready to put it into action for the weekend. This concludes the severe weather briefing from the National Weather Service in Norman. With the potential chance of severe weather both Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, it is essential that you have a severe weather plan, that you're weather aware this weekend, and that you have that plan and you're ready to put it into action if and when a warning is issued for your area. Forecasts do change and the weather is constantly evolving, so be sure to check our webpage at www.weather.gov/Norman for the latest forecast, warnings, and watches. Be sure to stay tuned to local media outlets and stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio for the most up-to-date forecast as well. You can also like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, where you'll continue to get more information from the National Weather Service here in Norman. I appreciate you logging on and listening to our briefing, and we'll see you next time.